Welcome to more TMS WEB Core 2.0 greatness. This video will look at a few framework additions. We will focus on two important additions to the framework. First, material icons have been improved. Various components, for example, buttons and page sheets, have the ability or had the ability to add material glyphs. Now you can also choose the type of the material glyph if you want the icon to have a normal appearance, an outlined appearance, round appearance, sharp, or even with two-tone colors. The second addition we'll look at is a component wrapper for CSS classes. The bridge between the web and controls on your form is much tighter because of this. You just drop a T-Web CSS class component on the form, and all its properties reflect properties of a CSS class. This makes designing CSS much easier when getting started with the web, because the control slowly guides you to the new terminology. Material icons is an icon collection from Google that will make it much easier for you to use icons that are common on the web. You just type in a keyword and you can be quite sure that material icons has an icon for you. For example, here, let's click on the material icons library. It's available at fonts.google.com/icons. And then we can search, for example, for cart, if you want to build something with a shopping cart. And here's all icons that deal with shopping cart, with selling, a shopping bag. And I'm quite certain that you immediately recognize these icons because you surely have seen them before. Let's say you want to use the shopping cart. You click here, and then you get all the different alternatives how you can use this in your application. For TMS Web Core, the only thing you need is the identifier of that icon. And you'll find that right here, inserting the icon here, shopping underscore cart. That is the icon ID, so to speak, that you will need to remember. And new in version 2.0 is that these icons are available in outlined, rounded, sharp. And in addition to those three, TMS Web Core also supports two-tone icons. Here's an example that I created quickly with TMS Web Core. All the different tabs have a material icon. And in addition to just using the icon as it was available with TMS Web Core 1, you now get four additional styles for your material icons: outline, rounded, sharp, and two-tone. I don't know how good it is visible on the recorded video, but inside of this user icon, there is a darker gray than the button gray. So it has two tones. So there's definitely two colors being used. Looking at the project itself, at design time in the Delphi designer, you do not see the material icon, but the T-Web bit button here has support for material glyphs. So the glyph ID person is being used on this button. As a color, we use black. The size is 32 pixels. And for the glyph type, we pick normal. The other buttons have different types, as you can see, outlined, round, sharp, and two-tone. And going back to the example that I presented at the beginning, if I type in shopping cart, you realize pretty quickly that TMS Web Core has autocompletion in the list of all available material icons. So there is no way you can type in the wrong material icon because TMS Web Core actually gives you a list of all the icons that are available. Just by changing the ID, you have a different icon. With a new support for material icons in TMS Web Core, you can build attractive, modern, recognizable user interfaces quickly. The T-Web CSS class component wraps everything that a CSS class has to offer as a Delphi component. I selected the T-Web CSS class component in the form editor, and here on the right in the object inspector, I see all the properties that are supported by CSS. If you so far struggle what is available with CSS and rather define everything in the form designer, this is the component you've been waiting for. This component allows you to interactively build your cascading style sheet class. The total hierarchy of all the properties is supported. That means, for example, border left is not just a value. No, it is a class of TCSS border that has additional properties. This is rapid application development at its best. Each CSS class needs to be identified by its name. This component is no different. Just be careful, don't use the name property. You have to use the CSS class name property. So this is named MyFirstCSS. Let's look at this div, for example. What is the CSS class name that is being used? MyFirstCSS. So this way you can tie any user control on the form editor to the new T-Web CSS class. Naturally, as this is Delphi, you can access all the properties at runtime. So looking at the Change CSS button, you find examples how to influence the settings of each of those CSS classes. For example, here we change the background color to yellow or to a different color if it already is yellow. You have full access to any of the properties, also to the shadow of a box, for example. Just be certain to call update CSS after you make any changes on the respective CSS control. Running this application, we see right away that our CSS definitions have been applied to the two div controls. Furthermore, clicking Change CSS really applies the changes that we've looked at before in code. But wait, there is more. Unlike Disney, in its latest animated feature, we always talk about Bruno and with Bruno. And Bruno enjoys talking to you in his webinars, presenting new features of TMS Web Core. This webinar is no different. If you go to the link on this slide, you get a full webinar for free where Bruno Ferenc presents all the features of TMS Web Core 2.0 in detail. And if you haven't downloaded TMS Web Core yet, go to web.tmssoftware.com to find more information, download links for your version of Delphi.